Hello, everyone, and welcome to RevMD, Sex Bites Podcast with me, your host, Dr. Deborah Durst, and I have Faraday with me, my co-host, and so I'm going to have her say a few words, and then we'll get started.
Hi, guys. My name is Faraday Golombieski. I'm a family nurse practitioner here at Revitalize, and today we are in office for the holidays, as you can see with the tree behind us, to talk about metabolic syndrome and erectile dysfunction and how they're related and why you need to know about it.
Mm-hmm. Why it's important. So we did do metabolic syndrome or metabolic disorders in the past and talked about that. And so we'll just briefly overview that again so you know. So basically, as we age, we'll start to notice some changes. And again, that's when we not only notice bodily changes, but we'll might see an elevation in lipid panels or blood pressure, weight, waist, and all that. And that's considered metabolic syndrome. So if you see like an abdominal waist, you're gaining weight, you know, and
your
all those other things that go along with it.
Yeah, exactly.
That's when you want to start thinking metabolic syndrome. So there's actually specific criteria, which we'll go over. I'll let Faraday run those down. She's much more detailed with that than me.
So this will be a quick rundown. You can always go back to our podcast on our Revitalize RMD cast, and we go into a lot more detail. But essentially, metabolic syndrome is you've got to have 3 of 5 criteria to meet it. So that will be 1, a waist circumference in men greater than 40 or 35 in women, a triglyceride level at 150 or higher, an HDL, which is your good cholesterol, for men less than 40 or for women less than 50. Abnormal blood sugar. So whether you already have a diabetes diagnosis or pre-diabetic diagnosis can be part of that, but it can also just be abnormal blood sugar where we're getting there, where we're starting to see that process happen. So a fasting blood sugar of 100 or greater and a hemoglobin A1C of 5.7 or higher. So it's looking at blood sugar over a 3-month period. And then the other one is, did I miss one or did I get all 5? Oh, blood pressure.
I think you got, yeah, so above 135 over 80. Right?
Yep. Yeah. So an elevated blood sugar or blood pressure as well.
And I would almost venture to say that again, like those are higher numbers than you really want acceptable. So blood pressure should be 120 over 80. That should be your goal. Anywhere between 120 to 140, you know, 80 to 90 really needs to be brought down to 120 over 80. That's your goal, like hemoglobin A1C, 5.5 and below, and not 5.7. And so, you know, those lipid panels, all of that are, they're giving you a little leeway.
Already.
Yes, already. So taking that into account. So when you start to gain weight and you have abdominal waist circumference that's larger than it was, and you're noticing body composition changes, you know, need to start thinking metabolic disorder, like your body is not metabolizing like it should. And that's why that's happening. And so then if you're at the doctor's and you have high blood pressure and you have elevated blood tests, you know, because it's not just numbers. And
exactly. Yeah.
But why it's so important to start thinking about that, because some people avoid the doctor, right? When they start to notice changes and then they know that their blood pressure is going to be probably elevated. They don't want blood work done because they know their lipid panels are going to be abnormal.
Or guys, I hear it all the time. It was just a little bit elevated. It's really not a big deal.
Yes.
I hear that all the time from guys. Less from women, more from men. They're like, it wasn't bad. Oh, I was stressed that day. Oh, I had a pre-workout drink. Mm-hmm. I had coffee.
Mm-hmm. Well, and not only that, again, if you're on medications already for it, and then you tell us your blood pressure is normal and your lipid panels are normal, they're not, because you're on medication for it. So
exactly.
That counts. You are abnormal and treated with medication to go into the normal range. So that still counts. But the reason why all this is so important, men, is because if it's not affecting it yet, it will affect your erectile strength and quality. And so that's why you want to know about it. Don't avoid the doctor. Don't avoid some behavioral changes and choices you can make
exactly
to keep everything functioning the way you want it to.
Yeah. So we talked in our last podcast a little bit more about numbers, but about 1 in 3 Americans have metabolic syndrome over the age of 50. So when we're talking about that and we're thinking about that, that's a large number of people that have this, but you don't hear about it at the doctor. They might say, oh, your blood pressure is elevated. Oh, your cholesterol is elevated. Mm-hmm. However, when you have multiple things going on like that, that's where it becomes a syndrome or disorder of the metabolic system. And what Dr. Dersch is saying is why that is so important is because it can affect erectile function, and it can affect it significantly. Mm-hmm. The Journal of Sexual Medicine and the Journal of Men's Health came out and said that men with metabolic syndrome with abdominal obesity, so that big belly guys, that 74.7 of those men reported erectile dysfunction. That's mm-hmm. huge. Mm-hmm. That's a large number of men to have erectile dysfunction. So we know it's causative, mm-hmm. right? If we have this large abdominal fat, if we are at a higher risk for cardiovascular disease, if we're putting pressure on those arteries, we're not getting blood flow like we should. And that's what erections are, is mm-hmm. blood flow. And you want blood flow. You want
80%,
good blood flow.
80% of erectile changes, erectile dysfunction, is a blood flow issue. About 20% of it is hormones. So you want your hormones to be optimized, but blood flow has got to be there. So if you start to notice erectile changes, loss of nocturnal erections, morning erections that aren't as strong erection. Or aren't spontaneous or aren't there, those are erectile changes, and that's when you want to address that, because the arteries in the penis are the smallest in the body, 1 to 2 millimeters. And so they're a barometer of vascular health. So if you're starting to notice those changes, then again, you're going to end up with other changes, and that leads you to increased risk of heart disease and stroke. But men, you respond better anyhow to erectile changes. Yes. And so if that function's affected, then you'll probably seek some behavioral changes and some choices and maybe even a physician. But I would venture to say, if you're starting to notice some weight changes, weight gain, abdominal yes. increase.
If your belly is hanging over your pants and you've got to lift it to get your belt, we're talking to you.
Yeah. Yeah. Because that's the first thing. So some things we can do just to improve it with personal choices at home prior to even making a doctor visit. And again, a lot of men will put off the doctor because they know that their blood pressure is going to be elevated when they do blood work. Their lipid panels are going to be abnormal. They know this because they know they're not healthy.
And
yeah. So why not do it beforehand? And why not do it to keep your erection strong and your orgasm strong? And so in your sex life, incredible. So that's what we're talking. That's why we're talking to you, because if you're noticing those changes, if it's not happening for you now or happening to you now, it will, because yeah. it's a progressive disorder. Those are small blood vessels. They will get clogged and be unhealthy and affect erectile changes if those healthy lifestyle habits that can improve all the conditions in the syndrome, yes. Those need to happen for you to
so
keep
get out,
strong.
Be active. That's a huge one. Mm-hmm. Even yeah. 30 minutes a day to start. Be yeah. active. Clean up your eating, right? Look yeah. at diet. Those are big.
Sleep, stress reduction. And again, yeah. even if we were to look at activity, so American Diabetic yeah. Society, 30 minutes of walking 5 times a week, that's nothing. You know, that's yeah. very minimal. And so if you're not doing any walking, then, you know, get off the couch and put down the phone and get out and walk. And it doesn't cost money. You don't have to have a gym membership. And again, you know, make it more brisk, right? Faraday?
Exactly.
She's about the brisk, not just get up, but
don't
make
just
it
get
brisk.
Up. I yeah. mean, if you can be on your phone and walk your dog and sing and talk and have a conversation, your heart rate's not up. I mean, let's be honest. Yeah.
Walk faster.
Yeah. Pump your arms.
Yeah, exactly.
<Get moving. laughs>
That's right. And so that's the first thing. And that's a very basic level. But again, and if you're feeling those days when you really don't want to, I think those are the days when at least walk. You know, you don't have to go to the gym and pump iron those days, you know, at least walk. And that doesn't cost money. So that's the first thing, activity. You got to be active okay. to lose weight. And then healthy, you cannot exercise your way to a healthy body. You have no. got to do the nutritional part. It's absolutely necessary that you clean up your diet. Absolutely. And those are personal choices. Again, if you want rock hard erections, then you need to make sure that you clean up your diet so that those blood vessels stay healthy and open.
Exactly. And some of this is hormonal. 20% is hormonal. Mm-hmm. So there could be some hormone changes. But if we have excess fat, if we have excess visceral fat, if we are not eating clean or even making healthy choices, then mm-hmm. we're going to see those testosterone levels change. If we're consuming a lot of alcohol, that's another one that can affect testosterone levels in men. So be active, clean up your eating, decrease your alcohol intake, especially during the holidays, right? Because that's a little bit harder to do sometimes
Christmas
when you're out celebrating.
Christmas tree is behind us, so there's going right? to be some celebratory, you
lots
know, events.
Of holiday parties.
Yeah. So that'll be, so this month doesn't have to be, you know, the entire year. Next yeah. year. This can be just this month and you can still limit it and be active. Again, you can't exercise your way to a healthy body, but also if Absolutely. You have fat, like they talk about cholesterol and it's not always cholesterol that, you know, cholesterol is at the crime of the scene, but not the culprit. And so it's not just all cholesterol. So if they put you on cholesterol medications because your cholesterol is high, sometimes it can get so low that you're not producing hormones because cholesterol is the beginning of your yes. hormone pathway. And so it's going to make, you know, 20 plus hormones for you. And so if it's too low, that's a problem. So you have a healthy balance. And of course, some people have genetic predisposition to certain lipid, you know, disorders. But again, find out what your disorder is and do your part to help regulate that by Absolutely. Being active in a healthy diet. Absolutely. And sugar is actually the number one reason why a lipid panel will be elevated. Again, it's not fat, it's sugar that makes that go up. So carbohydrates and sugar, beer,
bread.
Yeah, bread, rice, pasta.
White potatoes.
Yes,
all the
that.
Yummy things
yeah.
that and we need to stay away from.
Exactly. And during the holidays, you know, cookies and desserts and all that. So Absolutely. Again, it doesn't have to be the year after. But what we want to do is just make you aware that if you're starting to notice body changes that bother you, then you're eventually going to notice some erectile changes that really bother you. Yeah. And so take
or
control now.
If you're already there and you know you're there and you're like, they're talking to mm-hmm. me, I have metabolic syndrome. It is not the end of the world. You can start making changes and you can start being proactive to reverse some of these things.
And you can reverse them.
Absolutely.
It is a completely reversible condition based on behavioral changes and choices that you make.
Exactly. With metabolic syndrome, men, you are 3 times more likely to have erectile dysfunction. It is 3 times more prevalent in men with metabolic syndrome. So be active.
And so that is extrapolated out from like diabetes. Like again, with yeah. diabetes, you know, you're at way increased risk for erectile dysfunction, but diabetes is just one of the many conditions in the syndrome. So really you go to your doctor, they put you on medicines for your high blood sugar. They put you on something for high cholesterol. They put you on something for blood pressure. Yeah. That's all a syndrome of metabolic, it's a metabolic syndrome, disorder, dysfunction. And you need to get at the root cause, which is being overweight and yeah. inflammation in fat muscles cause inflammation in your heart and your brain and the blood vessels. And so therefore the penile vessels do not work the way they should. So
exactly. And it puts you, you know, at risk for cardiovascular disease, mm-hmm. which also plays into blood flow. And that's mm-hmm. what we're talking about with erectile dysfunction is blood flow. Yeah. Plain and simple.
And then increased risk of stroke. And of course, if you have that, then your erections and sex is not going to be good because stroke-like conditions can affect nerve function and, you know, and much worse, obviously, we know that. So again, just being aware that if you're noticing changes or you're not making healthy choices, then we wanted to bring it to you men so that you know that it's going to affect your sex life eventually. And can be quickly. So yes. make those choices now. Take control. We always want men to take control, right?
Always.
So take control. You know, make those good choices and
that was
keep a active and very healthy and joyous sex life in your future.
That's it. We're reading an article on 8 fantasies that women yeah. won't tell you about. One of them was men taking control.
Yeah.
Take control, guys.
See? Yeah. We were just giving you that little secret, you know,
sneaking
the secret in to you during this podcast. So yeah, so just keep that in mind. And again, take control, men. Everybody wants you to, including you and your penis. So
Penis will thank you.
Your penis will thank you for sure. Your partner will thank you as well. So listen, if there's anything else that you want to talk about, you have any questions, just shoot us a comment. Anything that you've heard you want to add to or you want us to talk about in the future, let us know. Hit the bell, subscribe, like.
Share with friends.
Share with friends. Sharing is caring. Share these videos. Help all your male friends out because no men are out there talking about erectile dysfunction with
or metabolic syndrome.
No, they're not talking about it. So send this on to them. And again, let us know if there's anything else you want to talk about because we're willing to deep dive into anything sexual wellness. And again, we're here to revitalize your look, your health, and your
sex life.
That's right.